तस्माद् गुरु प्रपद्येत जिज्ञासु श्रियो श्रियमुत्तमम् शब्दे परे च निष्णातं ब्रह्मणि उपसमाश्रयम् तस्माद् गुरु प्रपद्येत जिज्ञासु श्रियमुत्तमम् शब्दे परे च निष्णातं ब्रह्मणि उपसमाश्रयम् गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड बॉन्डेड सोल कैन शो सबमिशन अन टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ गुरु वैष्णव अप टू सर्टेन एक्सटेंट नॉट फुल्ली गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति शिशिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड Bonded soul can so exhibit submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma or Vaishnava up to certain level. If there is any breakage of self-interest, then and there he can throw relationship with Gurudev. They can break the relation with Gurudev immediately. The moment they are going to break some personal interest, in that case they can break relation with Gurudev. That is the kind of inclination usually bonded soul showing unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. At the same time it is 100% sure Guru Vaishnav never want to get any pratishtha, puja. Guru Vaishnav never expect any kind of puja from anybody. Because bonded soul, today they can worship. If they are going to lose some self-interest, they can kick tomorrow. That is the condition of bonded soul. Slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Pad Padma can ultimately throw you away from bhajan. Slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Pad Padma can ultimately throw you away from bhajan. Be careful. Your heart should be totally harmonized with Guru Vaishnava. That is the only way to get Kripa, no other way. Guru Ranugruhen Naivapumana Purna Prashantaye. By the mercy of pure Guru Vaishnava, you can get total satisfaction inside your life, in your life. Bhagavan Sri Krishna and that old friend Sudama Vipra talking in Dwarika. Krishna speaking, Gurur Anugrahen Naiva Pumana Purna Prasantaye. Only by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava you can get total satisfaction inside. Total satisfaction means you are going to get bhakti. Satisfaction means when a jivatma can get full satisfaction. When nectar coming inside heart, automatically light mathematics. When nectar coming totally inside your heart, nectar means bhakti. When bhakti coming, then you are everything finished, no problem. There is no desire, no dissatisfaction, nothing can exist in your life. That is the way out, procedure. You can remember that day I was speaking, that day I was speaking that Jiva Goswami Pad, the Tattva Acharya, giving some commentary on this sloka. Which sloka? Tasmat Guru Prapadeta Jigyasu Srivamityamam Sabde Parichani Snatam Brahmani Upasamasrayam. On this sloka, it is from Bhagavatam. On this sloka, Jiva Goswami Pad giving nice commentary, I am giving warning to you. What is that? If you are going to take shelter onto the lotus feet of some Sadguru, by the mercy of Baldev, not by your fanciful attitude. Let us go. I can take shelter onto a lotus, that Gurudev. His big populace, big influence there. We can go. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, you are all foolish, number one. In your whole life, first of all, try to be sincere. In your whole life, first of all, you try to become sincere. If you are sincere 100%, if your demand is perfect, if you feel this material world is nothing, useless, if you can feel that this material world is nothing, useless, so I need that kind of, you know, eternal love. You have to feel. In that case, you will have to think twice before taking shelter unto the lotus feet of Gurudev. Because if you are 100% sincere, in that case it is the responsibility of Baldevji Maharaj to guide you perfectly. If you are 100% sincere, if you are 100% sincere, then it is the responsibility of Nityananda Baladev to guide you perfectly, to arrange so that you can get a Sadguru. Bhaktivinoda Thakur requesting you all, Bhaktivinoda Thakur requesting you all, don't be busy, don't run here and there. Don't be busy, don't run here and there to accept Gurudev very quickly. Today I need Gurudev. Foolish. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, don't be busy, don't run here and there. If you are sincere, it is the responsibility of Baldevji Maharaj to guide you properly. If you run here and there and if you be busy to accept one Gurudev very quickly, in that case big problem. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, don't be busy. You wait and see. Automatically Baldevji Maharaj can send one information to you which is perfect, genuine. Otherwise you are going to die. I mean spiritual death. Spiritual death. You cannot, you know, get benefit out of that. That is the main problem. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur requesting, maybe in your whole life, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, maybe in your whole life you are not getting information about one Sadguru. Maybe. Still okay, you wait. You wait. Then someday you can get help. Tathacharya Srisila Jiva Goswami Pad giving one warning before us. If you are going to take shelter unto the lotus feet of a Sadguru, Krishna Bhagavan giving definition, Shabde Parechani Snatam Brahmani Upasamasrayam. Shabde Parechani Snatam. Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma. Though Sabda Brahma is equal to, just equal to Parabrahma. Sabda Brahma is just equal to Parabrahma, no problem. But still has some speciality. Shabda Brahma in the form of sound incarnation coming to help us through Guru Vaishnava. Follow? Sound incarnation going to help us through Guru Vaishnava. So, Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma mean, you know, that Supreme Lord Himself. Sabde Parecha Nishnatam mean, he should be totally, you know, verse in transcendental sound vibration, you know. Shabda Brahma, you should have total idea, clear idea. You should have a clear idea. You should have a clear idea. Total conception by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. I mean, what I mean to say? Gurudev, from whom you are going to take Diksha, he should be versed, totally experienced about both Shabda Brahma and Parabrahma. Shabda Brahma means he should have profound knowledge. I mean, knowledge means not that you are educated, you can memorize, not. Knowledge with feeling. Knowledge with direct feeling. Knowledge with direct feeling. So direct feeling you should have. And realization about that Supreme Lord, His mood, His activities, leelas, sabde parecha nisnatam, and Brahmani Uposamasrayam. Brahmani mean, it is seventh case ending in Sanskrit. It is seventh case ending in Sanskrit. Brahmani Uposamasrayam. Uposamasrayam means totally satisfied. Uposamasrayam. Have no dissatisfaction, no burning. Total nectar coming. His heart is totally full of transcendental bliss. No dissatisfaction. No dissatisfaction. That is the condition. Why Jiva Goswami Pada going to give this kind of indication to us? Because at present people, they are suspicious. They are suspicious. They don't have 100% belief in Guru Vaishnava. Maybe they can believe, maybe 50%, 20%, or 70%, 80% maybe. They cannot believe 100%. That is why Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, and Prabhupada also told, according to the degree of your inclination, according to the degree of your inclination, you are going to get kippa from the transcendental world. Not that you are having 20% belief and you are giving 100% kippa. Not that. It's not possible. It is ratio. In mathematics, some ratio. 20% submission, 20% belief, 20% kippa. 80% submission, 80% belief, 80% kippa. 100% belief, 100% kippa. Is an automatic factor. Jiva Goswami Pada giving warning, because suppose you are going to put some question in front of your Gurudev. Suppose you are going to put some question in front of your Gurudev, and your Gurudev cannot give a clear answer to you. Follow what I say. Cannot give clear answer to you. In that case, you are not satisfied. You become dissatisfied. You feel some doubt. Why Gurudev cannot give clear idea, clear answer to me? That's when my Gurudev is not perfect. Jiva Goswami was speaking. In that case, you have dilemma. Dilemma, you know, both way danger. Both way danger. You cannot leave your Gurudev. At the same time, you cannot accept your Gurudev from heart. Dilemma. Both way problem. You cannot leave your Gurudev. At the same time, you cannot accept your Gurudev from heart because you don't believe. That's why Jiva Goswami Pada giving this kind of indication. Be careful. One thing I like to speak clearly about this point. If Gurudev having full, you know, bhakti, if Gurudev having full satisfaction inside heart due to his transcendental relation with Gurudev. Suppose he is not going to read so much Shastra. In that case, what happened? In that case, suppose Haridas Thakur. Haridas Thakur not reading huge amount of books. Follow, be careful. Otherwise you can find some fault with me. If you cannot understand this point. Suppose Haridas Thakur is not reading so much books. He has a direct feeling about Krishna. At the same time, Shabda Brahma, Harinam, giving full kippah to him. And all Shastra present there in Harinam. Follow what I mean to say. All Shastra, the gist of all Shastra is already there in Harinam. In that case, if your mood is very soft, if you are very plain-hearted, you can get Dikha, no problem. Follow what I say. Namacharya Haridas Thakur can give Dikha. Because Shabda Brahma, maybe he is not going to explain Veda and Vedanta. But all the gist of Vedanta is there in Harinam. That Harinam he can give you. That is also good. But it depends. Follow. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu going to put one by one question to Haridas Thakur. You can remember about Harinam, how to deliver those bonded souls, how to deliver the Muslim people, Javan. Haridas Thakur one by one giving clear answer. Maybe he is not quoting one sloka from, but Mahaprabhu is totally satisfied with the answer given by Haridas Thakur. That is the most spectacular thing. You will have to be very careful. Another point I like to clarify today, you can remember, I was repeatedly speaking that day, those who are going to do Guru Seva, they become Guru. Now somebody can misinterpret this Harikatha. I was fearful. So night time I thought I should clear this point. I repeatedly that day told, those who are doing Sadguru Seva, they become Guru. Because without same level, you cannot do Seva. I am in bonded cell. My Gurudev is Sadguru. My Gurudev is Sadguru. His level is transcendental level. I am bonded state now. In that case, there is some gapping. I cannot do Seva. Gapping. So by the mercy of Gurudev, at least I can come to that level, same level, then I can do perfect seva. Follow what I say, perfect seva. Bonded condition, Gurudev can give some seva, that is different thing. But that seva is not perfect seva. They are doing, Gurudev allow, okay, you can do seva. Gurudev going to give me chance so that I can do some seva and come up. Gurudev giving me chance so that I can do some seva and come up. That is different thing. But in bonded condition, my seva, that time what I was doing, that was not perfect. That is why on behalf of Gauriya Math, I like to give you one warning. What is that? Those who are going to do Guru Seva and Vaishnava Seva, they should be very, very careful. Because out of 100%, if not more, 98% fall down we found. Those who are going to do Guru Vaishnava Seva, usually we find they can become fall down. Why? Fall down. Why? For that Guru Vaishnava is not responsible. I am responsible. Because they grow some material idea about Guru Vaishnava. While doing Guru Vaishnava Seva, they grow some material idea, conception. It's very dangerous. In that case, they fall down. Actually, one very important Siddhanta, if you like to get quick improvement, very quick improvement, rapid improvement, then there is one way. You will have to serve. In that case, you will have to serve pure Guru Vaishnava. If you want to get rapid improvement, very quickly, then you will have to serve pure Guru Vaishnava. But before serving, you must know the tattva of Guru Vaishnava. Without having clear idea about Guru Vaishnava tattva feeling, if you go to do seva, that is the reason for why maximum, most of the people, they fall down. If I am going to serve Guru Vaishnava, I don't know, I have no realization about Guru Vaishnava. I am going to serve Guru Vaishnava, but I have no idea about any tattva of Guru Vaishnava, how I can serve. Before serving the object I am going to serve, I should have clear idea about that object. If I have no clear idea about what is Vaishnava, what is the level, what is position, everything, then that is the reason for why we fall down. So you can remember, I am speaking very clearly that if you like to do rapid improvement, if you like to get rapid improvement, in that case the only way, you will have to serve Guru Vaishnava, rapid improvement. And at the same time, if you like to go down to hell very quickly, then you will have to serve Guru Vaishnava, negative way. That is the easiest way. So quickly you can go. Follow. That is the way. Dham Tattva is also Guru Tattva, Baldev Tattva. Dham Tattva is also Guru Tattva, Baldev Tattva. Follow. So this way, be careful. And that day I was repeatedly speaking, I should clear this point, that what I was speaking, those who are serving Sadguru Vaishnava, they become Guru. But don't try to misinterpret this point. Be careful. Those who are serving Guru Vaishnava from heart, 100%, without any self-interest, if he is going to fight with me, I can just give salagram inside in your hand and speak clearly. You expected something from your Gurudev while he was serving? You'll have to speak. Don't try to fight with me. Because I am speaking all Siddhanta, scientific Siddhanta. I have seen some so-called acharya fighting with me. Because I am not fighting with them, I am speaking Siddhanta. I am speaking so clearly, they are going to lose some self-interest, they become angry. And speaking, my Gurudev make me acharya. My Gurudev make me acharya. Your Gurudev make you acharya. Your Gurudev is not so foolish that can make you acharya. It is one kind of punishment given to you. It is one kind of punishment given to you that he make you acharya. Because you are not qualified. Maximum most punishment you can get through this procedure. If you are not qualified, If Gurudev knowing he want to become Acharya, you like to play trick with me, business with me, okay, I can make you Gurudev. You want to become Gurudev? Okay, I can make you Gurudev. That is one kind of punishment. I can show you. I can give example. Why punishment? Why this is one kind of punishment? If you are not qualified, if you are not qualified, if you want to get some benefit from Gurudev, if you want to put Gurudev in such a position, you want to get control over Gurudev, you want to become Guru, then Gurudev making you Acharya. In that case, it is one kind of cheating. Gurudev want to cheat you, make you Acharya. Why? This is one kind of topmost punishment. From Raman, I'm giving one example. In front of Ramchandra, why I am quoting this thing? I heard it from Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami. I remember this. Now I am going to clearly speak all about his glory. Clearly. Before that I am making background. One day Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami told me, very solitary self. He was in Bhajan Kuti, I was alone. He told me, one day in front of Ramchandra, one dog coming in front of Ramchandra, speaking about some, complaining. My master always beating me. The dog speaking in front of Ramchandra, my master always beating me. Why? What problem you have done? You have done some mistake, obviously. No, I have done no mistake. I am doing my own duty all the time, night time. I am staying like security man, everything. But unnecessary, whenever see, he beat you. I am just tired, I am just fed up. Please see, because you are controlling the rain. You are governing. So I am coming to you to get some justice. Ramchandra then speaking, okay, I can give him punishment. What kind of punishment you can give? I can make that man, Brahman, Acharya. Huh? Acharya of that temple. Huh? Acharya of the temple, he is one. I can make him temple of that. I can make him Acharya of that temple. Huh? Acharya, what kind of punishment you are going to give? Oh, you don't know. That dog speaking to Ramchandra, what kind of punishment you want, I give him. The dog, in front of dog, Ramchandra speaking, what kind of punishment should I give? What you prefer? The dog speaking, you should make him Acharya of that temple. Huh? Ramchandra speaking, why? Because I was Acharya. Previous life. If I become Acharya, that is very sensitive chair. If you make any mistake, you are responsible. In a mot, if somebody going to insult one Brahman Vaishnav, you are responsible. If somebody going to make problem with deity, Acharya is responsible. Follow. If somebody dishonor one guest, because guest is the form of Narayan. In that case, each and every time you are going to increase the level of sin, aparadha, apava, in your bank, you are going to increase. And if you can become Acharya like Ramanujacharya, Madhacharya, Vishnu Swami, follow. Even Balla Acharya was expressing some sort of popped up mood. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately break. Well, what you mean to say? You can remember? Balla Acharya, the great. He was acting as Acharya. He was expressing some, vanity. Mahaprabhu immediately crashed down. Follow? This way, actually, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami is so sensitive, Acharya. So sensitive, he can see past, present, future. He can see the heart of everybody. He can understand, feel everybody. This kind of Acharya can set everybody. Our Guru Bhargava, not ordinary. They have sensitivity inside their heart. You can remember, while I was discussing Bhagavatam, I was glorifying about Shukadev Goswami. Yam bravayanna manapetam apeta krityam daipayana virahakatar ajuha putrete tanmayatayataravo vinedu tam sarvabhut hedayam manam munimanatasmi tvam sarvabhut hedayam munimanatasmi. Why? In commentary it is written, Vishwanatha Chakravarti, Shukadev Goswami is such a great level Paramahansa. Shukadev Goswami can feel your heart, everybody's heart. Follow, try to understand. Why Vaishnava is so sensitive? Why the grade of Vaishnava is so high? Even Krishna say, Krishna speaking, Vaishnava is more than me. Vaishnava is more than me. Why Krishna speaking this way? What is the reason? The only reason here. Because Krishna like to give kripa through Guru Vaishnava, not directly. And Guru Vaishnava, only Guru Vaishnava can have that kind of sensitivity, which an ordinary man cannot have. Sukadev Goswami is topmost Paramahansa, and Sukadev Goswami can feel everything. Follow? Paramahansa, his heart is so great, so sensitive. Suppose one snake biting some man. Try to understand what I mean to say. Very sensitive point. Suppose a boy is bitten by a snake. Everybody running, coming. Hey, what happens? They cry. But the actual feeling, a snake biting, and the burning, the feeling, a Vaishnava can feel. One mother going to lose his son, just young. She is crying. When I was, you know, boy, I used to read in school. I read one post written by P.B. Seli, I think. I forget. Home they brought her warrior death. Home they brought, one fighter was fighting for motherland. Somehow he loses his body. And that body, somebody carry in front of that young wife. Follow, try to mean what I mean to say. Young wife. Just she was married maybe 2 years, 3 years before, or 1 year. I know, within two months, one lady in Chagda, Jagannath, she lose husband. She was hearing Harikatha from me, and from house, they suggested you will have to marry again. But that girl, that lady speaking, enough of it. That girl speaking, enough of it. I already get the feeling, the taste of family life. No, no more. I can do bhajan. I cannot marry anymore. Follow? When that warrior and the freedom and the fighter was dead, his body was brought in front of that lady. Follow? So somebody is speaking this way, somebody crying, somebody speaking, somebody. Follow? But on old lady, she was maximum most sensitivity there in her. She was not Vaishnava. I want to establish the final point. Now I'm speaking some ordinary thing. That old lady, she was experienced almost more than 80 years. Vast experience of material life. Sensitivity very high. Very love for small girls and boys, everything. That young lady, wife, cannot cry even. When fine husband is dead, his heart become like stone. Very immediately she can meet with heartfelt. Immediately what happens? That old lady, she was sensitive enough. She immediately go inside the room and take the small baby. Small baby, maybe 6 months or 8 months. Take that baby and put in the lap of mother. Follow? Go inside room, take the small baby in lap, and put the baby in the lap of mother. Immediately she burst into tears. She was very sensitive. Because if she is not going to cry, then she is going to meet with heartfelt. I am giving this material example. But be careful, the heart of Guru Vaishnava is so sensitive. They can feel everything. They can inside. That's why it is written in the commentary by Vishwanatha Chakravarti, as if when Vasudev Goswami crying, Oh son, come, son. Vishwanatha Chakravarti speaking, it seems that all, you know, stavar jangam, hills and river, they are going to reply. Because some echo coming. Putra, echo. Oh, putra. Follow. As if when echo coming, it seems, ka putra. Who is your son? What is your relation with him? So Guru Vaishnava having very sensitivity. They can feel everything. Now, actually, I was speaking something about how to serve Guru Vaishnava. I was speaking about how to serve Guru Vaishnava very clearly. Bandamui sabodhano mate. You can remember the kirtan. Bandamui sabodhano mate. Now, automatic speaking, I can serve Guru Vaishnava. Very carefully, so that material conception not going to touch my heart to make me fall down. Nice kirtan you are not doing. I know 100% you are not doing. Whereas I requested you, go and read that kirtan, try to get feeling. Tai shishyatab Tai Shishyatabo Thakya Sarvada Naloiva Pujakar. I am not going to take any worship of anybody. I am sitting in Vyasasana. Most sensitive asana. I never like people worship me. But I like if people hear Harikatha. I never expect. I hate. I should not speak that way, I hate, because one kind of then Vaishnavi Pratishtha I am going to throw. That's not. But I never like. But I like if people going to hear sensitive Harikatha. If people going to accept in their life, that is my worship. That is my pranami. That is my donation. If you accept all if you have any doubt, if you have any respect, then gradually I can cut your doubt. But if you totally express disrespect, then I have nothing to do. Because I am not manufacturing any Siddhanta. I am not manufacturing any philosophy, hot philosophy and coming, and I am serving you, not that. Very sensitive Siddhanta. So, I am speaking now today about... Now I will have to give full answer to the question. Those who are going to serve Guru Vaishnava from heart without having any smell of interest. Be careful. Many such instances I can show you. They serving Gurudev very nicely externally, but they expected something from Gurudev. And Gurudev is Vancha Kalpataru, we shielding tree. You are serving Guru Vaishnava, you wanted to get this facility, Gurudev can give. Guru Vaishnava can give. And one another point, very sensitive point, sometime Guru Vaishnava is bound to make some acharya. That doesn't mean he is just now equal to Gurudev. That doesn't mean. They think so. I am acharya, mean I am just equal to Gurudev. No. You will have to come to the level of Gurudev. You should think like Bhaktivala Titta Goswami Maharaj, I am most unfit a man. Yes, I have no quality. Gurudev want to, maybe Gurudev, I am just wicked man. Gurudev want to give me punishment. I mean, give me so much seva, attention. I am bound to pay total attention so that I cannot do any other activities. Then maybe for that reason, Gurudev give me the leader of all seva. You will have to do all seva, your seva. Gurudev give me pressure. Titta Goswami Maharaj speaking this way. Gurudev going to make you acharya, that doesn't mean you are just equal to Gurudev just now. Just now. As per Siddhanta you can speak. Gurudev make me acharya, you will have to have 100% belief that now he is equal to Gurudev. But you should not feel. We can feel. Gurudev make you acharya, we can feel you are just equal to acharya. But you have no right to feel that I am equal to acharya. That is one kind of vanity. That is the main ground for which they fall down. Try to follow my point. You have no right to feel. Why you feel? You have no right to feel that. On the contrary, you have to feel I am a bonded soul. Gurudev make me, give me total responsibility so that I can do more and more seva this way. And another point, very vital point. So Gurudev can make you acharya. But so long you are going to follow Gurudev in toto, 100%, then you can maintain your level. So long you are going to follow your Gurudev 100%, then you can get power, total power from Gurudev. Follow what I say. Don't try to manipulate. Then you can get total power from Gurudev. Otherwise not. Maybe Gurudev going to make you acharya, you are maybe qualified, we think you are equal to Gurudev, but so long you are going to maintain all the etiquette of Gurudev, all Siddhanta, Vichar, I mean you will have to get constantly in touch with Gurudev. You cannot break any Siddhanta of Gurudev, any etiquette, anything. In that case, you cannot get total power from Gurudev. You can lose power gradually and ultimately you can become Sahajya Guru. You can become so Sahajya Guru, you have no gravity, nothing. You have no value. You can become. So long you are going to get in touch with Gurudev 100%, up to that point you can get full power from Gurudev and you can act as Acharya. Not that you can break all the rules and regulations set by Gurudev, all Siddhanta, all etiquette. I am Acharya like Ravan. No, this is not Siddhanta. They are going to misinterpret. They are going to misinterpret. Gurudev make me Acharya. I am topmost Acharya. Who told you? You show. Your activities can prove. I should not speak I am Acharya. My activities can prove that I am Acharya. Follow. A tree is known by his fruits. What kind of fruit is there? A mango tree cannot give blackberry. Mango tree can give mango. This is Siddhanta. Follow what I say. Another question coming from foreign country, someday you are speaking that those foreign fighters going to give their life for their motherland. Oh, my mother, I can give my life for you. They are speaking? They are giving their life very easily. Whereas we have commitment in front of Gurudev. We have commitment in front of Gurudev. Gurudev, we are going to follow you 100%. Submission. Even we will have to give life for Gurudev, like Kuresh. Like Kuresh was ready to give life for Ramanujajo. Well, I can give life for Gurudev. Parampaya Keshav Goswami Maharaj was lion, just wanted to give life for Gurudev. Everybody attack, Prabhupada. Then Keshav Goswami told him, if I am the servant of Gurudev, then today I will have to show. I can give my life for Gurudev. That kind of heart you should have. I am not getting benefit, Maharaj. I am not getting benefit. My 20 years over, I took decision. I took diksha, everything. Oh, are everybody crying? Everybody crying. But I was speaking about this point that freedom fighter, they are going to give their life for motherland. Whereas I wanted to become pure Vaishnava, and I already done some commitment in front of Gurudev, whereas I am not ready to give life for Gurudev. Like Gurudev mean? To establish Siddhanta, Vichar, everything, to give full protection to Bani Vaibhav. To give full protection to Bani Vaibhav, to speak very clearly, like lion, if the whole world going to attack me, kill me, still I am ready. They can come and kill me. Many such incidents happened in my life. That is called Bani Seva. That is the main Seva of Gurudev. Now, some devotee putting question in front of me, that Maharaj, you told, those who are committing suicide, they are going to get maximum most punishment. Whereas you already told those who are going to live their life for motherland, they are not going to commit suicide. I already spoke. Why I spoke this way? Because those who are going to live for their motherland have some spiritual figure. Like India, Bharat Mata. Follow. Bharat Mata. Srila Swami Maharaj used to speak this way. Ganga, you can see water as some spiritual figure. Jamuna, you can see water. Foolish. But there is some spiritual figure, Jamuna Devi, Ganga Devi. You can see water, Saraswati. Oh! Some spiritual figure. You can go to Kamakha. You know Kamakha? Gopakuma. You know in Assam, Guwahati, Kamakha Devi. Yogamaya. Kamakha Devi, from Kamakha Devi, Gopakumar, Sanatana Goswami writing in Brihad Bhagavatam. That Gopakumar got Kamgayatri from mother. That Kamakama. Follow. But I say, understand. So you should feel, if you are Vaishnava, you should feel there is some spiritual figure everywhere. If your darshan is material darshan, then it's dangerous. Anywhere and everywhere you look, you should have some spiritual feeling. That is not a woman. Why you are looking woman? You should feel that Atma is there, inside this body. Why you see this is elephant? You should see some, you know, elephant is the outside structure, but that Atma is there. Why you look snake and tiger? Because you cannot, you are blind. But Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj is not blind. When Bihari is speaking, oh, tiger there! Who told you tiger? You go, no problem. tiger. If you have direct feeling inside snake, Krishna is there. That snake 100% cannot bite you. I promise you, I am sitting in Vyasasana. If you have that kind of feeling, that inside the snake Krishna is there, without the permission, without the indication of Krishna, that snake cannot bite me, then that's hardly, snake cannot bite you. But you cannot believe. Because, bhayam titiyo vinivishataha sat ishat apetasya viparya asriti. Tanmayaya ato budho avayatvam bhaktaika esham gurudeva tatma. That is a exact thing, exact mood of Guru Seva. You should feel it through Seva, Seva, Seva. Go on doing Seva. Don't pass lecture. We are less interested to hear lecture from you. We have no time. Who men care to hear your lecture? We want to know what kind of feeling you got from your Gurudev. What kind of direct feeling you got from your Gurudev. We are interested about that. We have no time to attend your dry philosophy. We have no time to hear. That is the main thing. So by now I clear everything. Follow, I say. Gurudev can make you acharya. Many times Gurudev making acharya, they fall down because they cannot maintain. They cannot maintain that kind of accuracy. They cannot get in touch with Gurudev. They can speak, Jai Gurudev, Jai Gurudev, Jai Pova. They can speak, they have mouth, but they cannot prove. You can shout, Jai Gurudev, Jai Gurudev, you have, but you cannot prove. Inside your heart you are saying, what you are speaking? Externally you are speaking Jai Gurudev. Internally you are going to expect some benefit from Gurudev. Externally, you are speaking Jai Gurudev. But internally, you are expecting some benefit from Gurudev. That is not Guru Seva. That's why we are not going to get any power from that gigantic spiritual figure. Sala Bhakti Paramapuri Goswami Maharaj, Paramvija Kesava Goswami Maharaj. Why? That is the only reason. We are actually businessmen. We are actually in fine form, if I speak clearly. If I am frankly speaking, then I am actually a businessman. Why? I need some interest. I am expecting some benefit. Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Nisringadev. Prabhu, a servant who is going to expect some benefit from master, obviously he is not servant, he is businessman. Prahlad Maharaj speaking in front of Nisringadev. The same thing I am speaking. He is my Guru Varga. So you have to feel this way. You will have to put some inquiry in front of, you know, yourself. What kind of expectation you have from Gurudev? Annabhilasita sunyam jnana karmadi anabritam anukullena krishnanu silalam bhakti ruttama. That kind of bhakti only you can get, only and only you can get by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava. There is no other way, no gateway. Only through this channel you can get. You can run, you can shout, you can give slogan, nothing can come. Only you will have to do that kind of seva. Follow. Srila Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is the embodiment of Trinadapi. My Guru Master told. Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Guru Padma Paramahansa, he told, Bhakti Vallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj is the embodiment of Trinadapi and embodiment of Sahishnuna, Tarorupi Sahishnuna. That kind of enduring power I have never seen in my life. Only I can read philosophy that those trees, they can suffer maximum most. Those trees, they can suffer maximum. But in practically I have seen that more than trees, that kind of situation cannot permit you to live there. One day I was so foolish, long ago I was young, I was disturbed by something happening in more, something, some problem happening all the time, politics. I approached Maharaj very secretly, nobody was there inside room. I was like foolish. I'm putting, Maharaj, I have one question. What question? When I am put into totally reverse position, totally opposite, not favorable, totally. In that case, how I can do bhajan perfectly and go out? This question I put it in front of my, though by the mercy of Gurudev I know, but still to confirm this question. Maharaj laughing. That time I was alone, Maharaj speaking, those who are doing Hari Bhajan, Babaji Maharaj, those who are doing actual Hari Bhajan, they never think I am put it into danger. They feel all favorable. I was very happy. Those who are actually doing Hari Bhajan, they always feel I am put it into right situation. What problem? No problem there. No problem. All favorable. Externally, everything opposite. But still, a pure Vaishnava, those who are doing perfect bhajan, they should feel, well, I am put it into a nice position. Very favorable. If by the mercy of Krishna, I am put it into the situation. It is favorable also. By the mercy of Krishna, I am put it into this situation. What problem? I should not have any complaint. I should not have any complaint. I should not have any dissatisfaction. Follow. By the mercy of Krishna. Tatte anukampa so samekshamanam bhunjan eva atmakrita vipakam ridbhag babubhir vidadhat namaste jiveto bhaktipade sadaiva jiveto muktipade sadaiva jiveto muktipade sadaiva. It is written in Bhagavatam. I change jiveto bhaktipade sadaiva. But sarvamate jo change. I can speak something about this. Try to feel this point. What a sensitive issue. Really so. Those who are doing bhajan perfectly, those who are loving Guru Vaishnava, they never feel, I am put it into opposite situation. Huh? You should feel, this is favorable position. Apparently you can, I am in Dasasan. I was little bit upset when everywhere, when speaking this kind of harikatha of fear, they all try to put me in trouble. They like to stop my harikatha. They want I go away from that place. So many things happen practically in my life. If you are in my position, you would have died. Somebody giving information, that now Maharaj is now in a village, winter, almost 5-6 degrees temperature, Maharaj is nothing, they are in ground, Maharaj sleeping. Maharaj can die. But still, they are not going to take me away. Because I am speaking high. Many such incidents happened, but I was upset. But finally I find, oh my God, it was good. I a little bit upset first. But very quickly I find, oh my God, it was the mercy of Krishna. It was the mercy of Krishna. When I am speaking this harikatha this way, they cannot find any fault. But they don't want I stay there. They go away. Okay, nice. This way, each and every time I was put it into problem, you would have died in my place before. My neighbor. But finally I discover, oh my God, all the blessings of Guru Vaishnava, Santo Goswami Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, Giri Maharaj, all coming, you know, true in my life. All their blessings now coming in the in each and every form coming in my life. I was a little bit upset. I felt, no, it is good. If I was there, if I used to stay there, but they don't allow me to do publication seva, this, that. And now I have chance to do everything. All Guru Vaishnava bless me and go, no, you go. This is not your life. You go, start publication seva. Your Guru must give you this seva, bani seva. Why you are begging chapati here in Brajavasi? Duk! The senior devotee say, I say, well, how to go, where to go, I have nothing. Then by the mercy of Nityananda, everything arranged. I started penniless, started everything. Penniless, started everything. Penniless, started everything, now everything happened. You think about the life of Swami Maharaj. 17 rupees, 18 rupees. If you buy some biscuit and legend, you can, 18 rupees nothing. One packet of biscuit is costly, you know, 50 rupees for those sannyasi they are taking. Costly. Follow. He believe 100%. That Prabhupada give me instruction, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, two times came in my dream, so it's when I am going to come out successful. Maybe, apparently I am defeated, but again I can go. And I came out successful. In this old age, you cannot expect to come down three times downstairs and come up three times up. Oh my God, my heart. I am now 70 years. He is gone. You cannot go down three, four times and come up. My ears bring all over the world. Right. Oh, by the mercy of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Be careful. Without the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, we cannot do it. We can do nothing. But we have some vanity. Oh, I have some quality. I have money, enough money. I can buy that Vaishnava. Vaishnava. And at present, this is the situation. Okay? Somebody speaking. We can give Pranami 500 rupees, all Vaishnava can come. Idiot number one. He has no darshan, he has no idea about who is Vaishnava. Those Vaishnava inside the grief, all the patishta of a whole world, inside that grief. But still they throw, like stool and urine. Inside the grief, don't try to put challenge with them. Because they are not going to accept any challenge. Because if they are going to accept challenge, they are going to do some so something. There is one kind of vanity. Inside their grief, all the patishta of whole world inside their hand. Money, position, rank, everything. Still they don't care. Useless. Like stool and urine. But when Vaishnavi Bhutishtha given by Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then he is bound to accept. But you are servant, you have no separate will. You should not have any freedom. Because you are servant. How you are expressing your own freedom? Guru Maharaj used to say, servant mean you should not have any free will. Only the free will, I like to serve Gurudev, I like to serve Krishna, that. But you should not have any free will. If you have any free will, which is not favorable, then you are not Shishya, you are not disciple of a Sadguru. Practically we see in the life of Bhaktivallabha Tirthagosvami Maharaj, the total situation in which he was put into, is totally opposite. Totally opposite, just reverse. But he always finds favorable. He know who is doing what. Tirtha Maharaj was not foolish. So many people, even disciples and Godbrother, they wanted to make fool of him all the time. They think he is foolish. He was not foolish. He was not foolish. He could know everything. Okay? You are at liberty. You are at liberty to finish your life. You are at liberty to crash down your life, own life, spiritual life. Up to the last moment of his life, he used to say, zero, 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 everything zero. Maharaj used to shout this way. Everything zero in your life. Because you are doing all opposite. You are speaking, shouting, last moment. Up to the last one, zero, zero, everything zero. You are doing all zero. You cannot get any benefit. You are playing politics with me. You are playing trick with me. You don't know. Guru Vaishnava is more than sun god. Guru Vaishnava is more than fire. Guru Vaishnava is more than Brahman. You don't know. That's why you like to play. That's why you like to play. It is written in Shastra. Banhi Suryo Brahmanibhyo. Banhi Suryo Brahmanibhyo. Tejyan Vaishnava Sada. What's written? Banhi Suryo Brahmanibhyo Vaishnava Tejyan Sada. What does it mean? Banhi is Sanskrit word. Banhi means fire. Suryo, sun god. And Brahman. Be sure about that. Be sure, 100%, that Vaishnava is more than sun. Vaishnava is more powerful than sun god. Vaishnava is more powerful than... If you are burnt up by fire, somehow you can apply medicine. If you are going to burn your hand, somehow you can go to hospital and get some treatment, apply some medicine. Maybe after 1 year or 6 months you can recover. But don't try to play tricks with Guru Vaishnava. Burnt, totally finished spiritual life. Totally finished. Spiritual life totally finished. That's why it is written. Banhi Suryo Brahmani Bhyo Tejyan Vaishnava Sada. By the mercy of Guru Maharaj, I could realize something about Guru Vaishnava. Chitta Goswami Maharaj. Externally, you cannot understand. Externally, you cannot understand. You can feel, cannot feel. Like ordinary man is doing everything. Follow. I can remember the day I took white vest from Guru Maharaj. The day, I can remember, long ago. That time, Guru Maharaj was not sick, okay. Guru Maharaj is there, in most sensitive place. What is that? Purushottam nam Nilachal Khetra. Why I speak sensitive spot, Nilachal Khetra? I am not speaking, Bhaktivinoda Thakur told. Bhaktivinoda Thakur told, for Rupanuga Guru Vaishnava, that Nilachal Khetra is the topmost place to feel the mood of separation. Viraha, that is the topmost place. Where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself doing Leela, exhibiting all the time, every fraction of second. Bhaktivinoda wanted to establish this point that Nilachal Khetra is the most sensory place. You can get maximum most benefit. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to stay there. There Guru Maharaj in Rasa Purnima day, nobody there. I am alone, Guru Maharaj alone. Guru Maharaj give me. Whole night Guru Maharaj not sleeping. Whole life I was not sleeping. I was at rooftop. That time you can sleep clearly, Jagannath temple. Every clearly. Now so many hotels, everything you cannot see. Everything clear, Jagannath temple, Wales, Sudarshan, everything. Then morning time, Guru Maharaj called me, I took bath. After Anik, Guru Maharaj called me, I was alone, joking with me so much. And after that, giving this base, with loving mood, I was asking some question. After that, I took permission from Guru Maharaj to come back. Because some seva was there. Quickly I come back to Calcutta first. Because no train is there directly going to Mayapur. So first I come back to... Because it was my target. After taking base, Srila Bhaktivallabh Tirtha Goswami was the first man with whom I meet. After taking base, I was feeling shy to meet anybody. So I took decision, I must meet Srila Bhaktivallabh Tirtha Goswami first. When I reached temple, Calcutta, then the in charge of that man, that was very nice man, his name was Rishikesh Maharaj. He took me inside the room of Bhaktivallabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. He took me inside the room of Bhaktivala Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. That time there was no pressure. Room was just closed. I open, enter. No gateman, nothing. Later on, so much restriction, regulation. I, Maharaj, can I come? Rishikesh Maharaj, take me and enter into inside room. As soon as Srila Tirtha Goswami Maharaj looking at me, Shyamala Krishna, white vest? Who? Oh my God! Why? You should have taken sannyas. This way he is joking with me. I prayed Dandavat with humble but saying, Maharaj, I cannot preach. You can preach. Ah, you should not have taken white vest, you should have taken sannyas. Speaking this way. Inside giving me blessing. Inside, he is speaking, no! Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj, the topmost Vaishnava. He was there in preaching party, doing kirtan, giving kippah to everybody. You must stay preaching. He told me, I am assassin. Intact what Tirtha Goswami Maharaj says, I am relay, I am doing relay. You will have to do. This way, Srila Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, you know, always giving kippah to me. When, by the mercy of Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, because Srila Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Goswami Maharaj was not ready to go to foreign country at all. But he came in front of my Guru Maharaj, he told, Maharaj, those foreign people, they also have some desire to get kripa of Guru Vaishnava, you should go. They are also fallen soul, they should go there. You must go. No, Maharaj, I am just unfit, I cannot go. No, you must go. Oh, you are giving me order, yes. Then I can try to go, but if I am actually bonded soul, if I go to foreign country, how I can meet? After that, Srila Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Goswami started foreign preaching. And first, I was the first instrument. I was the first instrument with Tirtha Maharaj to go to airport to bring them, speak Harikatha. It was a standing instruction. It was a standing instruction of Bhaktivedanta. You will have to go to airport. Oh, Bodhan Maharaj, you send Shyamala Krishna very quickly. That time I was red cloth. After that I took first and second. So, after that also. This way, actually foreign preaching started. And Bhaktivedanta Tirtha Goswami Maharaj used to go to foreign country with full troops. Maharaj used to say, don't never try to go to foreign country alone. Tirtha Goswami Maharaj used to speak repeatedly. Don't try to go to foreign country alone. Try to go with some devotee. So that you can keep yourself safe. Repeatedly speaking, but nobody going to obey. Nobody going to obey. Maharaj repeatedly told, you will have to go to the group. Somebody should be there to give some guard. Otherwise you cannot maintain your character. You cannot. Not possible. Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj used to cook. I can show the picture of Swami Maharaj. Naked body, maybe with some clothes, cooking. Cooking himself, offering old age, so much power, giving lesson to them. You are not qualified. You wait. You will try to learn. He used to cook everything, offer everything. This way actually, the case of Swami Maharaj is totally different. Swami Maharaj went first alone. If you compare with Swami Maharaj, it's not good. A separate case. Because total, you know, material world, Swami Maharaj by that time, Swami Maharaj could see the naked picture of all this society. No interest, nothing. Swami Maharaj was matured enough. Nobody can do anything. the naked picture of this society, Swami Maharaj could realize, oh, this is society. There's no desire, no feeling, no desire. That case was totally different. Follow? Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj used to go to foreign country, not for money, not for position. Those disciples or some devotees asking, Maharaj, all Maharaj going to foreign country, they are some god brother speaking to him. Maharaj, those Maharaj, they are going so much dollar they are getting, you are not, you are going to, you know, cut your own pocket. You are spending your own money going to foreign country. Tirtha Maharaj speaking, I am not going to foreign country to collect money, position, nothing. I am not going to foreign country to collect money. I can spend my pocket money and go there and speak Harikatha. Okay, that's okay. Whole life Maharaj proved this point. Not that dry philosophy. Maharaj in his whole life proved this point that I don't want money. For money I am not going for preaching. Even I know personally one sevak speaking. Funny. Morning time, it was 9 o'clock, some sevak coming and speaking to Maharaj, today what we can cook? No sabji is there. No sabji there. No, nothing. Don't speak to them. Take money from me. Go to market, buy sabji. Don't speak to them. Don't speak. Some Maharaj used to go, spend money and come back. Many such situations happen. I directly heard some Switzerland, which place I forget, I cannot remember. Or America, some place, I forget. Philadelphia, I cannot remember. Some spot. I live in the life history of Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. By the desire of Maharaj, I was bound to write life history very quickly. Short life history. It was Bengali and Hindi, but English not yet translated. I request Prasad Prabhu to do it, because you have done so much, but he is speaking, I have no time. Say, I'm waiting. I can do, but I will have to leave all other seva. I can do. By the mercy of Tirtha Maharaj. Follow what I say. In that book, I already give this point. I heard from some sevak, Maharaj, we went there. Rajani's ashram or that kind of thing. I cannot remember that place. Dangerous place. They actually, Maharaj went and sitting, some young lady, almost naked, giving leg towards Maharaj and sleeping. Open place. Maharaj without any reaction, sitting, because they are ignorant. Again in Russia, which place I cannot remember. I write in book already. Maharaj was in Bhajan Kutir. Some Mataji, young Mataji, almost half naked, more than half naked, enter the room of Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Maharaj like child, look at him. Like child. 1, 2 years, 5 years child, looking at her. She feels shy, try to cover everything and go out. Maharaj has no reaction, like child, 5 years child. I can remember another point. Follow? One Russian godbrother. I mean, he took initiation from my Guru Maharaj. Kamalaksha, his name. Kamalaksha speaking, Maharaj, it is strange. My mother in whole life never meet with any sadhu. Know nothing about who is sadhu, who is not sadhu, nothing, no idea. Only she feels some, you know, inspiration, I don't know how. He was very... Then she came and wanted to meet Srila Bhaktivallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. That time Maharaj was alone, no problem. Shevak was there. Kamalaksha, he is speaking himself. Maharaj, my mother entered that room, even don't know how to pay Dandavati, is nothing. No. No, nothing. Because he don't know who is sadhu, who has, only his, she is looking at, only she is looking at Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Only she is looking at Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha and started crying, like mad. Maharaj not speaking anything, only looking at Maharaj and crying, like mad. Kamala Kuspiji, we don't know the reason for why she is crying. She can also cannot trace out, but she is crying. Unknown reason. When look at Tirtha Maharaj, feel some reaction and started crying. This kind of so many incident I can speak, but time cannot permit. All the glories of Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, my Shiksha Guru, he wanted to cheat me sometime to check up. You can go with me to America in Krishnagar Mart. Maharaj, I cannot go to foreign country. You are actually my Gurudev. No, I am your godbrother. No, you are my Gurudev. You are my Shiksha Guru, I told. No, actually you are my godbrother. You can go to foreign America with me. Maharaj, I cannot go. You can go, you can preach. Many times wanted to cheat me. But finally, he was bound to give me kippa. When in Vrindavan Math, so many so-called devotees wanted to play politics with me, try to make me out of Math, that time I write a strong letter to Tirtha Maharaj. Strong letter meaning? Deep feeling. After that write, I am putting a challenge in front of you, I promise. I am going to get your maximum most kippa. It is my resolution, kippa. I promise. Nobody can get maximum kippa. I can get. Though you can feel I am your godfather, but I think you are my Shiksha Guru. All the glories of Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj. Srila Bhakti Vallabha Tirtha Goswami Maharaj ki jai. Tadya tira bhaptiti maha mahasab ki jai. Vancha kalpataru shikipa sindhu bhavacha pachitanam pavanam bhavishna pyo namo.